This video is going to be about adding and subtracting fractions. So let's start with an instance where the denominators are the same. And basically, if you've got an addition or subtraction problem with fractions and the denominators are the same, all you have to do is add or subtract, whatever the sign tells you to do, add or subtract the numerators. So I've got 3/7 plus 2/7. 3 plus 2 is 5. And the denominator is going to be the same. If this was a negative sign, if it was 3/7 minus 2/7, I would subtract 3 minus 2, I'd get a 1, and once again the denominator would stay the same. One more where the denominators are the same, so I've got 3/4 minus 1/4, 3 minus 1 is 2, I've got 2/4, and then the thing to remember is look at your answer and see if you can reduce it. So I can divide both the 2 and the 4 by 2, and that's going to mean I get 1/2. Okay, but basically, when your denominators are the same, just do the operation that the sign tells you to do, addition or subtraction. Keep the denominator the same, and the numerator will become the new numerator, the result of addition or subtraction. Okay, let's look at what happens when the denominators are different, because that's where people have the most problems. All right, we've got 1/2 plus 1/4. The denominators are different. We have to find a common denominator. In other words, we have to find some number, some way of turning either one or both of these denominators into the same number as the other. So remember, I can change a denominator if I multiply it, which means I have to multiply the numerator by the same number. So to change this, I could change this 2 into a 4 if I multiply by 2. So I'm going to multiply the denominator by 2. That means I have to multiply the numerator by 2. Now, if you think about it, all I'm really doing is multiplying by the fraction 2/2, and 2/2 is the same as 1, so I'm multiplying 1/2 by 1, and that's not going to change its value. Okay, so let's do that. 2 times 1 is 2, and 2 times 2 is 4, which is good because I want to have the same denominators. Now I'll copy this part. I've got 1/4, so I've got 2/4 plus 1/4, and that's going to give me 3/4, or 3/4. Okay, here's another one. I've got a 2/3 minus 3/5. Now, I can't change a 3 into a 5. I can't change a 5 into a 3, so I have to change them both into the same number. And what I'm going to do is find the common denominator. I want the smallest one I can find. Sometimes this is called the lowest or the least common multiple. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to take the 3, and I'm going to multiply the 3 first by 1. 3 times 1 is 3. And then I'm going to multiply it by 2, and that's going to give me a 6. Then I'm going to multiply it by 3, and that's going to give me a 9. It's just if I'm counting by 3s. 3, 6, 9. Then I get a 12, 15, 18. Each of these numbers is a multiple of 3. And I'm going to do the same thing for the 5. So 5 times 1 is 5, 5 times 2 is 10, 5 times 3 is 15, 5 times 4 is 20. And what I'm looking for is a number, a common number. In other words, a number that's in this list of numbers and in this list of numbers. And I want the smallest one I can find. That's going to be 15. What that tells me is I can turn a 3 into a 15, and I can turn a 5 into a 15. So to turn a 3 into 15, I'm going to have to multiply it by 5. And that means I want to multiply the numerator by 5. Because once again, I'm just multiplying by the fraction 5/5, which is the same as 1. And then to change this 5 into a 15, I want to multiply it by 3. So I'm going to use the fraction 3/3, because that equals 1. So now I'm going to do the multiplication and see what I get. 5 times 2 is 10, and 5 times 3 is 15. I've got a minus sign. 3 times 3 is 9. 5 times 3 is 15. Now my denominators are the same. I found my lowest common denominator, or my least common multiple. That's a 15. So I can subtract 10 minus 9. That's going to give me a 1. Copy that common denominator, and I get 1/15. I can't reduce 1/15, so that's going to be my answer. Let's look at one more. I've got 3/4 plus 1/6. I can't turn a 4 into a 6. I can't turn a 6 into a 4. So I want to find the least common multiple, or the lowest common denominator, for both of them. So I'll make a list of the multiples of 4. I've got 4 times 2 is 8. 4 times 8 is 12. 4 times 4 is 16. 4 times 4 is 20. Let's go to the 6. So 6 times 1 is 6. 6 times 2 is 12. 6 times 3 is 18. I've actually gone too far. I've got a 12 and a 12. So 12 is the number I want to turn them both into. So how do I turn a 4 into a 12? Well, I know that 4 divided into 12 is 3. So 3 times 4 would be 12. So I want to multiply the numerator and the denominator of this first fraction by 3s. And then to change a 6 into a 12, I'll multiply numerator and denominator by 2. So 3 times 3 is 9, and 3 times 4 is 12, and then 2 times 1 is 2, and 2 times 6 is 12. My denominators are the same. Oops, I want a plus sign here. My denominators are the same, so I can add the numerators. 9 plus 2 is 11, and 12 is the denominator. Now, let's look at this one more time. Let me write these again. 3/4 plus 1/6, because I want to make a point here. Let's say that I didn't see this 12. So I kept going, and I added a 24 over here, and I found that 4 times 6 was 24. So I thought my common denominator should be 24. And I want to give both of these fractions the denominator of 24. So I could multiply 4 times 6, and that would give me a 24. And I could multiply 6 times 4, and that would give me a 24. So let's see what happens. 6 times 3 is 18. And that's going to be an 18/24. And 1 times 4 is 4. This is plus 4/24. My denominators are the same, so I can add them. Add my numerators. 18 and 4 is 22/24. Let me rewrite that here. 22/24. But both of these numbers are even, so I could divide them both by 2. And that would mean 22 divided by 2 is 11, and 24 divided by 2 is 12, which is the same number I got up here. So the reason I did this was to show you that if you don't get the lowest common denominator, or the least common multiple, in other words, if you don't get the smallest number in the denominator, that's possible. That's okay. What it's going to mean is you'll probably end up with a fraction that you have to reduce. And once you reduce it, you'll get the original answer. So as long as you look at your answer and make sure that you reduce it if that's possible, it's going to be okay if you make a mistake and you don't get the least common denominator or the lowest common multiple, whatever you want to call it, if you don't get that immediately. Okay, so that's all there is to adding and subtracting fractions. Again, the best way to understand this is to get plenty of practice, so please practice them. Take care. I'll see you next time.